Hi, I'm Dr. Tony Infante. I'm a pediatrician, a clinical immunologist, and professor of pediatrics at the University of Texas Health Science Center in San Antonio. Recently, I got a text message with a picture in it from a patient's mother that I take care of in our medical system. This boy's name is Logan. He just turned 3 years old, and this is a picture from his third birthday party. His mother, in that text message, thanked me for taking care of him over the last 2 years and told me that she thought that without my clinical help that he might not be here today. I want to tell you my story of how I got to that point and how I gained the privilege, really, of getting messages like that from parents. Well, when I was in medical school, I did what's called a combined degree program. I got a medical degree, an MD, and I got a PhD, a degree in scientific experimental science. And I was training to be what we call a clinician scientist, which sounds like a complicated thing, but in reality is just a way of expressing the idea that I was learning how to be a detective. But maybe not a detective like this stuffy guy with a pipe and a tweed jacket, but you know, I aspire more to be like this fellow, solving medical problems by looking at clues in the laboratory and applying new technology to the problems. Early in my career, a wise old professor of mine introduced me to a large family with a bewildering array of signs and symptoms that had baffled their doctors for a long period of time. They made antibodies that destroyed their blood cells, but they didn't have lupus. They had an enlarged spleen and big lymph nodes, but they didn't have leukemia or cancer. They had signs and symptoms of inflammation, but we couldn't find any infection. So I did the routine clinical tests that were available at the time. I took blood samples back to my bench and I did assays on them. I called collaborators from around the country and I read the literature of new reports that were. Finally, I decided that I had a good idea of what was going on with this family. And I got some collaborators from the National Institutes of Health in Bethesda to come to San Antonio and draw blood samples that were analyzed. And we showed that they had a disease that was newly discovered at that time called autoimmune lymphoproliferative syndrome, or ALPS. And that allowed us to treat this family, to give their condition a name, and to improve their health. Using that data, we published a paper in the Journal of Pediatrics, a leading journal in our field. The article was seen by other academic doctors and scientists from around the country. They quoted the paper and they cited it in their papers and review articles. You know, it was all very satisfying from an academic standpoint. But then an interesting thing happened. A few months later, I was sitting at my desk in my office and I got a call from a stranger. The woman on the other end of the line said, "Dr. Infante, you don't know me, but my son's pediatrician saw your article in the journal, and by reviewing it, he was able to determine that my son has autoimmune lymphoproliferative syndrome, ALPS, and I just wanted to tell you how very grateful I am that this condition, which had baffled so many of her son's doctors, actually had a name and that there were things that could be done about it to make his life better." So I thanked her humbly, maybe mumbled something appropriate, and hung up the phone. But I thought to myself, that's it. That's really why I do what I do. That's what justifies and makes sense out of the long training, the many hours at the bench, the long hours in the clinic. Getting back to the story of Logan, one of the things that excites me about the current state of the art in my field of pediatrics is that not only can we determine specific names of diseases that patients have. We understand the mechanisms that are behind those diseases, and that allows us to develop what are called targeted therapies, which can get right to the source of the condition and help the improve the signs and symptoms. When I first met Logan, he had a lot of symptoms. He was irritable. His gait was unsteady. He could barely sit up. He had an itchy, blotchy rash that made him uncomfortable. He had evidence of inflammation around his brain and spinal cord. His parents, both healthcare professionals themselves, were growing increasingly frustrated with the inability of their doctors to make a specific diagnosis or to suggest useful treatments. They were actually beginning to resign themselves to the idea that maybe no one would ever figure out what was going on, and there wouldn't be anything that could help Logan, let alone provide a cure. When they consulted me, their doctors were thinking about using drugs called corticosteroids to suppress the inflammation to try to make him feel better. But as medical doctors know, corticosteroids, while they're powerful anti-inflammatory drugs, have a lot of unintended side effects, and they create a lot of what some people would call collateral damage. So I studied Logan's condition using the same detective methods that had worked for me on previous occasions. And I came to the conclusion that one thing that could tie together his signs and symptoms was the body's mechanism of inflammation. And I knew that there were new drugs that were available to target the inflammatory response that might turn off the disease at its source. Kind of like these smart bombs here. So I made the diagnosis in Logan of something called neonatal onset multisystem inflammatory disease. Again, another mouthful that we abbreviate as NOMID. And because of that, I knew that there was a good chance that a drug called anakinra, which blocks one of the key substances in the body that causes inflammation, something called IL-1, could treat his symptoms. And indeed, within a few weeks of starting this medication, Logan began to act more normally. He wasn't as irritable. His rash completely went away, and the biochemical markers in his blood of inflammation all improved. A few weeks after that, his mother called me, almost in tears, and she said, "You know, I used to think that Logan was just an irritable child with a personality that I would just have to put up with. But now I see that after treatment, after getting this inflammation under control, that he really has a sweet personality. Thank you so much." And so once more, I thought to myself, that's it. That's why I do what I do. Now as I've gotten older, I've made cases like these part of my teaching repertoire for younger doctors. And I get a real charge out of teaching young healthcare professionals how to look at problems in a scientific manner, how to make a diagnosis, and how to institute targeted therapies. As the associate chairman for research and academic affairs in our department, I enjoy bringing this spirit of detective work to the younger faculty members and making it part of their repertoire as well. So my career has been one where I've gone from treating individual patients to one that I can make an impact on the lives of patients far away, and then I can make an impact on patients in the future through passing on this knowledge to others. So that's what I do. That's why I'm proud to be in academic medicine. That's why I'm proud to be a member of the Department of Pediatrics at the UT Health Science Center, San Antonio.